Good evening. I'm Ken Boxer, and this is Around the Town Live. Tonight is a very, very special night. It's special for two reasons. First, tonight is our 50th show of Around the Town Live. We here are all extremely excited about that. The second reason tonight's show is special is because tonight we have with us in the Around the Town studio this year's Penthouse Magazine Pet of the Year, Ginger Miller. Now remember, if you have any questions for tonight's guest, don't hesitate to call. Our number here at the studio is 963-3893. Again, that's 963-3893. Now, please call. We'd like to hear from you. If the lines are busy, just keep trying. We'll try and get all of your calls in this evening. Now, our guest this evening is Penthouse Pet of the Year for 1989, Ginger Miller. Ginger is well known for her modeling career, as we all know. She has appeared in many rock videos. She's also been in the Rodney Dangerfield film, Back to School, and the TV series Hunter, but now she's involved with her own business in Los Angeles, selling unique fashions in her own store called The Broad Squad. Now, we'll have to find out more about that later on in the hour, so I'd like to welcome to Around the Town Live, Ginger Miller. Ginger, you weathered the storm coming up to Santa Barbara today.
Oh, I can't believe it. I thought it was supposed to be sunny palm trees layout.
Well, welcome to Santa Barbara. It's not the most beautiful day today, but
it's not too bad, though. It's still pretty. Yeah. It's nice, yeah.
If you can tell us all, what's the most that's changed for your life, becoming the Penthouse Pet of the Year?
I'm a lot busier. A lot busier. I don't know. It's good for discipline. Oh, I'm a lot richer. I have a lot more money. That's a big major plus. I didn't want to say that first.
Oh, but wait a second. You can quote exactly how much the Penthouse Pet of the Year has
raised. You know why I can quote it down to the penny? You know what's really funny? It's because I'm having to deal with taxes right now. You have to pay gift tax when you win a lot of gifts, like on a game show.
Uh-huh.
So I won $279,870.40 worth of gifts. Down to the penny, as Uncle Sam would tell you. So, so basically a lot of things.
That's all in like cash and prizes, right? It's not just cash or...
Well, there was not much cash, a little bit, mostly gifts from like our advertisers in Penthouse, you know, basically. A lot of electronics, a car, a fur coat, a car, what am I saying, a car. A $160,000 LeDrain Magnastar. it won't be delivered until April, so it's not really real to me yet.
Uh-huh.
I don't know. It better be something incredible. I mean, I can't imagine $160,000.
Wow. We have, by the way, a caller.
I have to drive it. Oh, great.
And, from Santa Barbara. So again, if you have any kinds of questions for our guests, call us 963-3893, and we're going to try and get to a phone now? No, not just yet. Yeah, we can right now. Let's give it a try. Yep, you're on the air, Around the Town Live. Who do we have, Frank?
Yes, I'd like to ask the beautiful lady if she's ever going to be in any movies, and does she ever go out in Santa Barbara in any of the local clubs or anything?
Thank you for calling.
Oh, does that mean should I answer it, or are you just like, that's it? Well, see ya. Okay, thanks for calling. Bye. Well, let
you're
me think.
You're still there calling.
Okay, what was the question? No, I'm kidding.
The question is when you're in Santa Barbara.
Well, I haven't really been in Santa Barbara. This is actually my first time. I was here once for 3 hours, but I just like went inside somewhere, went out, went back home on the freeway. So I guess to clubs, no, I don't really go to clubs in Santa Barbara. But
what was
the beginning of it? Yeah, that's what I would like to know.
I wanted to know whether or not you're going to be in any movies. I mentioned you were in the Rodney Dangerfield movie, Back to School. You're also going to be, I know you're in a lot of rock videos.
Oh gosh, you know, I actually went through a period where I decided I wanted to be quote unquote an actress. So I started reading for a lot of films and going on movie auditions. I did a lot of movies. I worked on Back to School, The Midnight Hour with Sherry Belafonte Harper and Vincent Van Patten. And then I worked on Sins of Our Fathers with James Coburn. What else?
But you told me before when I'm there, you're glad it's all over. You don't want to do any modeling, though. Is acting something that you want to go
No, into? No, I don't want to act either. No, I'm tired of being a puppet, you know what I mean? I'm tired of dressing up. It's like I'm an overgrown girl still playing dress-up, and I just want, you know, I want to stop.
Is that what acting's all about, though?
Yeah, it is.
Adults and child play?
I don't know. It's like I'm rebelling against the standard. You know, I don't want to do my makeup. I don't want to do my hair. I don't want to wear high heels.
Thank God for Marilyn, our makeup person. Marilyn, thank you.
Oh, really? I know. I jumped out of the tub and came over here. That was it, you know? Uh-huh. Poor lady. I felt sorry for her. It's like, hi, here I am. Good luck.
We have another call. We have Alex on line one who is, let's see, we're going to get to it. Alan, are you there? Alex, I should say. Excuse me. Alex? We have Alex on the line. Nope, we're not. Not right this moment.
No, I'll see ya.
But okay, you got the magazine.
Bye.
Alex is probably going, oh, I'm on the line. Wait a second, something's happening. What's now going on? You did some rock videos. Mm-hmm. Did you like those more than the movies?
Well, no. Well, no, I can't say that. These rock stars are like crazy. They're crazy. They're crazy people. I was telling you earlier about David Lee Roth drinks like Jack Daniels for breakfast. So this is the scenario. You go to this interview. There's 5,000 women. They all look the same. They're all wearing bathing suits. They all act the same, pretty much. And then David Lee Roth comes in the room, and we all line up in our bathing suits, and he kind of walks like a peacock in front of all of us, you know, his little strut, checking us all out. And then, like, you know, he picks like a few girls out of the line, out of all of them that all look alike anyway. And then you're going to be like the lead in the video. So we went on top of the Sheraton Grand Hotel in downtown LA, and we made like a beach scene on the roof, and they filmed it like we were on the beach, and then they like panned back. And he was just really, he's definitely what he looks like. He is. He's a rock and roller. The videos are fun, you know. They're interesting to see what kind of people you meet working on them, and what kind of people, you know, the rock stars are, the crew.
Are you?
It's really interesting.
You've been traveling now for about 4 months. Are you tired with the whole rat race? I mean, jetting in, jetting out. Is it fun for you still? Are you liking the limelight at this point?
Well, the best thing about Penthouse is it's a really good company. You know, they send me out a lot, but my contract is only for 3 days a week, which is nice, gives me time off. And I go out of town about 3 times a month. Actually, I'm like, you know, I've been traveling like constantly. I don't even remember what my house looks like anymore.
What's the, you know, Penthouse is the fantasy magazine for men, predominantly men. What is Ginger Miller's fantasy?
I don't know, but it must be something really crazy, because some of the stuff I come up with is really wild.
I want to hear about that.
So,
you know, there's so many crazy, I mean, before the show, let me tell my audience, this gal's wild. I mean, you do the craziest things.
Do I?
Yes, you do.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh, really?
Uh-huh. You can right off the plane, right into the restroom, had a bumpy flight, stay there for 20 minutes.
Oh, that was the worst. That was so bad, that flight. Oh, it was terrible. Here I am thinking I'm going to get ready in the plane, you know, be casual, eat something, change my clothes, you know.
So she comes off the plane, I got to tell everybody, you're coming off and you're like doing one of these, you know, just because the ride today.
Tiny little 12-person plane with like 5 people on it. It must have been like a lopsided, you know, too many people sat on one side and not the other.
And everyone's got going slow motion as she walks out slowly. Everyone's in that kind of going, oh,
it was so
no.
Bad.
You remember you did an interview today with Tom Carroll on the Tom Carroll Radio Show on KTMS. He's now, I believe, on the line. I think he's going to say hello.
He's going to call and say hi?
I think so, if we can get him on this line. Can we get to Tom Carroll right now and say hello to Tom? And he was kind enough to let us appear on his show. And is Tom Carroll all right?
But he's not doing an in-person
Here
appearance?
Here we go. Tom, are you on the line?
I certainly am. Hello, Ken. Hello, Ginger.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine. Are you the one? You're the one who interviewed me today, right?
Yes. I want to tell you, it was the shortest interview I've ever had in my life with anybody.
Oh, you're so fun. I remember. I liked him. He's really neat.
Well, I like you, and I must tell you that after you left the studio, after Channel 12 did the news story with you, several people came up and said to me, "Is she a bimbo?" And I said, "In 3 minutes."
Yeah, it's written all over her forehead, right?
Well, you know, you're gorgeous. You're the pet of the year. And people said, "Is she a bimbo?" And I said, "I've spent 3 minutes with this lady. I have watched her being interviewed, and I will tell you, no, she is not." And I was very pleased to discover that, because so often we meet, as you know, a lot of, and you know this, Ken, we meet a lot of people in this business who really are bimbos, and you're not. And I was very pleased to say that.
Oh, well, thank you. Coming from you, I'll take that as a big compliment since you've met so many of them.
And it is a compliment. Ginger, let me ask
you. Oh, my gosh.
Just recently on our show, we had a controversy going on about pornography.
Right.
The pro, we had a con. I believe Penthouse came up. Now, you know, a lot of people in this world and in this country believe that doing a centerfold without the clothes and so on is pornography. Other people saying that's ridiculous. God made a beautiful body. Why shouldn't it be shown?
Right.
Let me ask you, what is your opinion? How would you define your role in the Penthouse magazine and, of course, as Pet of the Year?
I can answer that for Tom. Look at this. You just stand up. Stand up for a second. Come here for a second.
Oh, my gosh.
Look at this. Stand up, people. Very cool. Look at this. Do you see? Look. Do you see this body, Tom?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
That's what makes
yes.
the centerfold. And the Pet of the Year. Okay, have a seat.
I love
this by accident, by the way.
I love it, and I like your outfit, too. But how would you define that, Ginger?
Okay, heavy question now. All right. I don't know. I guess I feel good about what I did. I don't feel like I was really involved with pornography. Then again, I don't so much really feel pornography is wrong, so maybe I'm not the best one to judge. I guess my answer to that would have to be that I think everything has a tolerance level, and some people might be offended by maybe a religious program. Some people would be offended by a nude magazine. I am offended by some things in pornography. I don't know. I guess nudity and pornography are one and the same. I don't really know, but I feel good about it. I don't feel like it's pornography. There are certain ways that it can be done that it's definitely, I think, considered pornography.
Well, not only are you a bright lady, but you're very gorgeous, and I wish you nothing but good luck for your career.
You're a sweetheart. I really had fun today. I wish I could have stayed longer.
I wish you could have, but next time you're in town, I hope we can arrange to have you back on the show.
Well, I'll be fine next time. I'll just walk here, you know. I'm not going to fly.
Tom Carroll, thank you. We're going to be listening to you on KTMS, your news authority. Is that right?
That's where we are.
Okay, thanks a lot, Tom, for calling.
And one final thing.
What's that?
Don't you dare go away.
That's his trademark. We won't go away. Thank you, Tom.
Thank you,
thanks for calling on our 50th show, Tom Carroll. You know what we're going to do right now? Our director, Carrie Graffy, put together a little montage of some of your pictures. And you haven't seen it yet. What we're going to do is we're in the studio going to
see. Did you do something great with them?
She did an outstanding job. You're going to see this. Everyone watching, you're going to see on your monitor, I mean at home, you can watch your TV sets, see some pictures of you, and she put it with some music and also. We're going to surprise you with this right now.
I love it. My own little rock video,
why don't we look at the video
right
now, and if we can go to it, let's see it.
Yeah.
Great, it's like my own personal rock video, huh?
I like that. Kara, thank you very much. Some of those pictures were taken right from the magazine. Mm-hmm. Were those taken throughout a period of time, or the one day? How long was the shooting?
I was in New York for about 2 weeks, that's all.
That's it?
Yeah, it wasn't very long.
Tell us about chickenpox?
Chickenpox.
About
3 weeks before I left, I was going to Las Vegas and I landed and I had these red dots and they were itching and they just kept spreading and spreading. And I said, chickenpox, measles, no way. I had them when I was young, you know. And so I went to the doctor when I went to Las Vegas, he said chickenpox. So I laid down in my bed for like 3 weeks. I was there with itchies, the horrible, horrible itchies. It was so bad. 5 pair of socks on my hands and I'm still itching. And then so I flew immediately to Canada to begin shooting the layout, and then I flew to New York after that, and it was like, you know, little chicken pox all over the place. And Bob won't airbrush anything. I don't know whether it's because, you know, he says he believes that a woman should be shown the way she really is.
We're going to talk about Bob Buccione in just a moment, the founder of Penthouse, but we have another caller. Remember, our phone number here is 963-3893. It's Stephen. Stephen's on the line. Can we get to Stephen? Let's see. 963-3893 is the number. Stephen, you're on the air live. Stephen, are you there?
Hello.
Yes, Stephen, you have a question for Ginger Miller.
Yes, I'd like to ask Ms. Miller. She is probably desired by thousands and thousands of men. How does that make her feel? I mean, does she go through sort of like an ego trip, or is she sort of fascinated by the idea that she's sort of like the dream girl of so many men out there?
Thank you very much. Good question.
It's a good question. I guess I can answer that by saying I just think men are crazy. Men are absolutely crazy. What they like, you never know what's going to strike their fancy, and I guess I'm just really lucky that I'm one of those things.
What strikes your fancy?
I don't know. I see a lot of men. I'll tell you, I mean, not date a lot of men. I don't date any men. That's the worst part. You see a million of them, you can't date any of them. I see so many men. You know, we do like a convention in Las Vegas, and there's a line like going around the corner, and you can't see the end of the line. You know, there'll be 140,000 people at the convention that week. And so it's just so many men that you can't really choose one. You know, you can't say, well, I like this guy or I like that guy.
But if you could say, you know, for everyone who's watching, what would be the fantasy male in your mind? What would that be?
Well, I like nice guys. I don't like guys that are too rich, because, you know, I like them better if they have potential, you know, because then they're kind of hungry, you know, they work hard. I don't like them too good looking, because I just think that it's a waste of their time. Just a nice guy, maybe an accountant, somebody I can really learn from, you mm-hmm. know, or, I don't know, real estate broker, somebody normal. Somebody normal, it's not somebody like in my line of work. Yeah.
Well, I want to talk, like I said, about Bob Guccione and your relationship with Penthouse and the Broad Squad. So we'll be doing that in just a moment.
We've got
so
plenty
stay
to
with
about.
Us. Yeah, there's lots more to
lots
come.
Lots more to so talk about.
In just a few minutes, so stay with us. We're going to this message. We'll be back right after this.
Vincent's, a center for the developmentally disabled. Children, teenagers, and young adults are learning to make relaxation a part of their daily lives.
Pull back up.
This group is leading relaxation exercises.
Pull your arms up again slowly.
Sharing time for relaxation in groups and teaching others what they have learned is reinforcing to their own learning. Through this relaxation program, they learn awareness of muscle tension, relaxation exercises and techniques, and self-control. If you or someone you know would be interested in more information, please contact us, St. Vincent's in Santa Barbara, or call 683-6381.
Feel how good it is to have your shoulders relaxed.
Thank you.
Hey, we're back. You're watching Around the Town Live. This is our 50th show. The phone number is 963-3893. And by the way, we're extending the show this half hour. If you're planning to watch Arts on Video, that's coming on at 10 o'clock in its entirety. So stay with us, and you're going to enjoy the show as much as all of us in the studio are. We have Ginger Miller. Ginger, the relationship with Bob Guccione and Penthouse and the Pets of the Year, what is that relationship? Is he very domineering? Is he close to the gals? What's the relationship?
You know what he is, actually? He's the most elegant person I've ever met in my life. Not because he's my boss or because I work for him, but because he just is. He really doesn't hardly say anything at all, and when he does, it's just something nice. You know, when we shot the layout, I did the makeup and the hair, and he used no assistant at the time. So it was just him and I shooting.
He does the shooting?
Yeah, he shot my Pet of the Year layout. He's a very good photographer. He actually started out as a photographer and then started the magazine after that and owned it.
Well, we're going to talk about the contest in just a moment. We have a caller. Alex is on the line.
Oh, Alex came back. Okay.
Alex came back. Let's see if Alex is going to... Alex is on? Alex, are you there? You're on the air live. Alex?
Hi. No, this is Joan.
Joan.
I'd like to ask, like an Alex.
Hi.
Did her parents have any objections to her appearing in Penthouse? I mean, did they back her or were they against it or what?
Thank you.
Actually, my father works out at Edwards Air Force Base. He works for McDonnell Douglas, which is an aerospace company. You know, flight tracking. Actually, he's very smart. He's so smart you can't even speak to him. You know, he's on a different level. You know, but he raised myself and my sisters by himself, and at a very young age, he got the three of us girls, kept us together as a family, and he has a very open mind. And I can remember, you know, I grew up with Penthouse on the toilet. You know how it's always there on the top? It's funny, and as a joke recently, I put mine there in my house. I was laughing.
Oh, really?
But I'm sort of like the mascot out where he works. They have like my posters up, and when they go out to fly in their F-15s or something, they pat my poster and, you know, give it a little, you know, I don't know.
Let's talk about
the centerfold is up at work, too. He's very proud of it.
And rightly so. The contest itself, how is the Pet of the Year chosen exactly?
Honestly, it's kind of by process of elimination. You know, when the girls screw up, they get crossed off the list.
Whoever's left.
Well, you know, just little things. You know, pay phone calls, or you just are kind of irresponsible. Maybe you're late more than others.
Uh-huh.
You know, little things that the company doesn't like. They're very much a company. There's no, like, hanky-panky, and there's no room for it either. You get cut quick. You talk about losing your salary. It's one way to do it. But basically, it's a process of elimination. They judge on the readers. You know, the readers write in. I get a lot of letters. I get some of the craziest letters. You should see. One man sent me like his centerfold of himself. Took all these little Polaroids of him doing all these like poses. It looked like his own camera that he'd like set the timer and he'd run back over and like do this thing with his whole Chippendales routine on.
Do people treat you differently? I mean, like as if you're.
After they find out I'm a centerfold?
Exactly.
Oh yeah. Oh, definitely.
For better or worse.
Well, it depends on what you're doing with them.
Let's get down and find out what this means.
There we go. That's the honest thing. Yeah, it depends on like who they are in your life. You know, if there's somebody you know, it doesn't mean anything. But business-wise, as far as the store, it's great. I get more business. More men buy my clothing than women. I really don't. I don't understand why they're coming in. They buy these bathing suits.
Oh, I think I understand.
You know.
But wait, we're gonna try and get that Alex on. Is it Alex that's on the line right now? Let's try Alex. Can we get to the phone right now? Okay, Alex, are you there?
No, this isn't Alex. This is Julie.
Who's this?
This is Julie.
Julie.
Hi, Julie.
Hi. I just want to say, Ginger, I think it's great what you're doing, but I just got to tell you one thing. Ken, I really like your show, but that Tom Carroll is really obnoxious. I couldn't believe I was hearing him on TV.
You don't mean that, do you?
But anyway, Ginger, I think it's really great what you're doing. I saw you on Larry King.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
You really impressed me in the interview.
Really? Did I?
Yeah, you did.
It's funny. You never know how you're coming off to other people, you know.
No, I thought you were really great, and what you had to say was really good.
That's nice. I thought I was boring, you know.
Yeah, you were pretty straight. You're pretty.
Well, good. Thank you. I appreciate that. Thanks.
Okay. Thank you very much for the call. This is now my Larry King impression. Now I've watched that show too, and Larry King's like this. He's just staring intensely into your eyes, and he's saying, "Let's see." Penthouse and Playboy. Let's see, is it Penthouse a little racier than Playboy?
Yeah.
Yeah. And your response?
What did I say?
Oh, I think it's a little bit, but not as much as Hustler. Or
really, I just, I just wanted to, the whole time, I wanted to just like shake the guy up. I kept trying to push buttons. You know, I wanted to like find what would make him tick, what would like break this whole bit like this.
Larry King. Okay.
Uh-huh. Yeah. That's so I kept trying to think, what can I say to like really shock this guy, you know? But you have to be really careful on a show like that. You can't just, you know, let it all hang out. You have to be, you have to watch what you say.
Were you surprised at becoming the pet of the year? Did you know, who knew in advance that you were going to be the pet of the year? Besides Bob Guccione, maybe his family and his sister and his aunt.
Let me think. Well, you know, the decision is up to Bob and Bob only. And when he tells you, then you know, and that's all who knows until they make the public announcement. I was told in November, but they didn't even make the announcement until December, you know, December 30th. Actually, no, it was December 4th, that's right. It was sooner than that. So Bob makes the decision. He doesn't tell anybody till he's good and ready, and they keep you waiting. You know, they put four girls up for semifinalists, and it's like the worst competition, you know, because everybody's going to all the same promos.
And now, you were a pet of the month. What year were you in the month?
I was Miss September 1986.
We have.
I was 18.
Alex is going to try again. Alex, let's try.
We have Alex again?
I think so. We're having problems with it. Okay, remember, 963-3893. Alex, let's give Alex a try. Maybe it's going to be Julie or... Let's see.
Is all better?
Alex?
Uh-oh.
Alex, are you there? You're on Around the Town Live. Hello?
Craig?
Yes, hello?
Craig?
No, speak in English.
Nope, we're not going to have a question from our...
Alex went to bed.
Oh, yeah. He's not going to try it. But let's now go into the Broad Squad. One walks into the Broad Squad.
That's a definitely interesting subject, I'll tell you.
Now, that has nothing to do with modeling, essentially, does it? Or it has nothing to do with television or motion pictures. Here's something, entrepreneur skills at its best.
Right. Well, you know, it's funny. It's sort of like taking the fringe benefits off of the entertainment industry and turning it into an actual business. Because all of my customers are in the entertainment business. All of the girls that work for us at the store, I have a partner. She's 33 years old. Her name is Cindy. And she's about as wild and as crazy as you could possibly imagine a person to be, and then some. I'm very serious on this. You can't spend 7 days a week with this girl. You'll go nuts. But she's great. She's very creative and energetic. So between the two of us, we have a great business going. You know, we make about anything. You know, we have garbage bag dresses, studded bras. We call it provocative Hollywood clothing.
And did you make this what you're wearing, by any chance?
No, this is Michael Holbin, Northeast Leather. I have to give him credit because he gave this to me as one of my pet of the year gifts. And we don't really make leather. All of our clothes are like a lot less fabric. Mm-hmm.
And your figures are just, just incredible, right?
Thank you.
And I've got to tell everybody, you eat well, you exercise. It's not something that you just all of a sudden, you're not taking care of yourself. Before you got on the plane, you were at the gym.
Right. I could be doing better, though. I could be doing better, really. I do take care of myself, and I really am trying to be on a very strict regimen of vitamins and water. It's very difficult when you travel, you know, you're always in different climates, you never know what the weather's going to be like, your skin's dry, then it's oily, and, you know, in 1 week I can remember being in 8 cities, an airport a day, a hotel a day, a city a day. I felt like I was just being dragged around the country,
Are we going to see another video of, you know, how to become this, how to become that, take care of yourself by Ginger Miller?
No, let them figure it out for themselves. Let them figure it out for themselves. I have bigger and better things to do.
All right.
I'd like to I want to expand my store into the Orient, into Japan and Hong Kong. Because there's a lot of things. If you have a good business sense, first of all, they make a lot of money off our country. You know, we really ought to be like getting something in there. second of all, blonde hair and blue eyes is a big commodity over there. And a few other things, you know. And I think if we did a catalog, I'd like to start with just a catalog, and just photograph a lot of pretty American young girls, you know, blue-eyed, blonde-haired, on the beach or whatever.
You said it was really easy to start up a business. How easy was it? You just win a Penthouse Pet of the Year contest?
Actually, I started it before. Yeah. It's easy. you know what it is? It takes a lot of dedication to follow through, step by step, follow through. I mean, you have to go through getting your business license, then you have to go through the fire codes, you know, the electrical wiring, God knows what else we ran into. You should have seen the place when we first got it. So it takes just a lot of time, it takes a lot of effort, and you don't always do everything the best way, but you have to get it done, especially when you have a lot of money on the line.
Well, speaking of time and effort, we're going to try and go to another caller.
Maybe
right now,
Alex?
Let's just kind of remember. Maybe it's Alex. Not. Maybe it's Lisa or Steve or
I'd
Alex.
To meet this Alex person. Is he an accountant? Maybe a real estate broker.
963-3893 is the number. Let's. Maybe it's Alex. Alex, is that you? No. Is it
anyway? Lisa.
Hi, Lisa. Hi. You are talking to Ginger Miller, Around the Town Live.
Yes. I'd like to know how to become a penthouse.
How do you become
a penthouse? That's a really, that's a very important question, because a lot of young girls end up doing the wrong thing, thinking that there's a lot of weird people out there. You got to be very careful. I think, first of all, most importantly, you can't take nude shots with anybody. Just make sure you take a shot of yourself in a bathing suit. Maybe just a family member can take it, or a friend, or even a photographer, but only in a swimsuit, and then send it to the magazine. And if they like the way that you look in the bathing suit or your face or any of that, then they send you to one of the staff photographers to, like, you know, get naked.
Is that easy for you? It's easy for me to do this. Wait a second. Has anyone ever seen Cinderella?
Thank you
Here
so much.
Here is a Penthouse Pet shoe. You got this shoe. Do you see? It's just like any normal shoe with a heel and... See what size are you? Six.
I didn't think my feet would be showing in this. Actually, I would have got a pedicure. You know.
Everyone, look at that. We can see right there. You're wearing a 6 medium with heels.
Yeah.
Now, how tall does this make you with these?
That's sample size. I used to do that for a living. I was a shoe sample model. You know, you stand behind a box and your feet dance around underneath. I did that for a long time.
And let's see. That's one. Oh, well, here's another shoe.
Taking the other one off. I've seen this happen before. You know, last time I did this, you know what happened? I ended up taking off a little more than I wanted and everybody saw everything.
God, there's, let's see, we've got scuff marks. See, she's human, everybody. She's human. We got one.
Boy, am I.
Do you know what this says right
Definitely
here?
To a fault.
It says, what does this mean, clean shine?
It means that is my shoe man who really gets very mad at me. This is like his life. My shoes are his life. Everybody's shoes are his life. He gets very angry when you bring them in and they're all like banged up. I bring them in every 3 weeks.
Ladies,
that's what it means.
Well, ladies and gentlemen watching Around the Town Live, here she is wearing a nice leather outfit. I forget the name of the designer.
North Beach Leather.
But do you want
Michael
to know
Holman.
Something about a woman and a man? Is that when you really want to know the class of a person, you don't look at their clothes.
You don't look at their hair.
You don't look at the breasts. What you do is you look at the shoes. Here's it.
Is that what it is?
You've got...
God, I've been missing out for a long time.
I've spent a lot of time
I got to start looking at some shoes, I'll tell you.
Everybody, this is the class of everybody. Shoes.
And I don't like shoes, actually.
No?
I never wear shoes. It's the first thing I take off when I go in the house.
Let's get one of Fanny's flowers, if you can. Let's kind of brighten up, get some class into some of your shoes, Ginger.
Okay,
let's do that.
This is something good to do with them, actually.
Here,
you want a tulip? Here's a tulip.
It's got to be a carnation, because carnations are at funerals, right?
Actually, we can leave these here. I really don't like these shoes that much. You know?
Okay.
So we can
leave
these here with the flowers.
Well, let's see if we can get to the car and make some sense out of all this. I don't even know who we have
at this
time.
Are these the ones you brought me?
Yes.
Are they?
No, they're Fanny. These are the ones. No, this is another one brought by Fanny's Flowers. And the bouquet that you have is out in the green room. Live on the air? Who do we have?
Tom.
Okay. You have a question for Ginger.
The man in the box. Hello.
Yes, Ginger. I'm a photographer.
Oh yeah, I've heard that before. Me too.
Ginger.
Did you know I work for Playgirl magazine? Would you be interested?
If you'd like to take picture of nudes, I was wondering. You said it's a good idea to start out taking pictures of them with their bathing suit on, and then would it be your choice to take your clothes off, or to say breast shots, or what?
He wants to tell me how to make this girl strip in front of him. This is good.
I like this guy. I love it.
Okay. Any other questions?
You got any other questions?
No, that's it.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
I love it.
You want to answer that?
Well,
there's nothing to answer, right?
No.
Basically, I think if a girl wants to shoot nude, she should know that she wants to shoot nude. You know, when I decided to shoot my centerfold, I knew that
It
was a decision that I wanted to do. I mean, I was running around doing all these little bikini posters, and I was on a can of cola. It was called Bikini Cola, and I was just in a bathing
suit. That was you?
Did you? No, you didn't see that, did you?
No.
You lie. Listen to you. It's okay. It made me feel good. So I was doing postcards. I mean, you know, I have 15 national posters. I ignore my modeling career now.
Uh-huh.
But I had 15 national posters and all these postcards and, you know, videos. It's all like in this cupboard in my house. Sometimes I open and look at all this stuff. But, you know, it was all this stuff that was an excuse. I mean, like little scraps of fabric that really didn't hide much. And everybody knows what's under there anyway. So,
do you guys know?
No.
Everyone's saying no. But I do have somebody that's in the know that knows that there's a call.
Great. Remind.
Okay, are you? Nope, we're not quite there yet.
That's it.
It's nice to have such state-of-the-art equipment on this show. Radio Shack equipment, luckily we don't have them as a sponsor. It's not the best.
Gotta be careful, you get a nasty note in the mail tomorrow.
Okay, some of the things that you won. You said you won this incredible car that you haven't got
yet. Okay, some of the things that I won, like how long do you have? You have a while?
No.
I have 3 pages of gifts. It's great. It's like Disneyland. My house is like, everything's fun. God knows when tax time comes around, it probably won't be so much fun anymore.
You shouldn't be admitting all this. No, we are all honest, aren't we?
What's that?
Taxes.
Oh, definitely. Oh, yeah.
$273,000.
$79,870.40. As my accountant said, you know, you went from being one of the poorest, youngest, singlest girls in Hollywood to being one of the richest, youngest, singlest girls. He said, and you're going to pay this year. And, you know, I went from making, like, a reported income of $1,200 because I was a student to making a reported, I got my W-2 form. It's just like for the last 6 months, $138,000. I just went, oh my God.
Okay, what's Ginger Miller's dream date?
Dream date.
What, if you can go anywhere in the world, money is no object.
I think big.
Let's say
money's
no object.
I've always had a problem with that with me.
Money's thinking big.
I'd like to go see maybe Les Miserables in Paris.
Do what?
Go see, or Phantom of the Opera would be even better. Yeah. You know, take the Concorde over
to
Paris.
So, I mean, if, like, tomorrow you can go somewhere, that's the first place you'd like to
go. I'd go tonight, actually. I'd leave, like, in 10 minutes or
hot.
So.
We've got a caller. Let's try and see if there's no more hum. Okay. Stephen, are you on the line?
Yes.
Oh, I don't believe it. Welcome.
Hello, Junior. We met earlier this evening, and we talked for a while, but I didn't really know
you. Earlier this evening?
Yes, we did.
Ah.
When you arrived in Santa Barbara. I didn't know who you were, and we talked, and it was interesting later to see the reaction of some of my coworkers who did know who you were. I was just wondering, how do you deal with harassment, and how do you know if somebody's sincere?
Let's role play. You little bitch.
You know? Nobody does that to me. I'd hit him. You know what I call it? I call it commanding respect. People treat you the way you want them to, and if you don't, then you just don't be around them. That's it. People don't really harass me. I don't know. I guess I don't really look like the sort that you'd harass. Sometimes somebody will say one rude word, but I've gotten pretty good at, like, you know, one sentence just like cut off and make me real obvious, you know?
Let's play.
Have a mean right.
Hey, here's what we're gonna do. Okay, let's see. Let's role play here.
All right.
Okay. First thing.
Look, you took your shoes off too.
See that?
Guy, can we order pizza? Like, you know, get a blanket.
Here we go. Now watch. First thing that enters your mind, okay?
Oh no, and, you're gonna be in trouble.
Okay, how about...
Do we have like one of those bleep machines, you know, in case you say a word that you can't have on TV?
Okay, you first start with the natural, innocuous kind of thing. Family. Your response to family, first thing enters your mind.
Family? Love, I guess, yeah.
Okay.
Definitely.
Love.
Yeah, family, there's only 4 people in my family, that's it. No grandmas, no grandpas, no aunts.
What about crowded rooms?
Crowded room? Smoky.
Parties.
Beer.
Which is your favorite beer?
You want like the first word out of my mouth, right?
Okay.
Okay, that's good.
How about bitch?
I can't say that. My sister sometimes.
How about talent?
A talent? What you make of it.
Entrepreneur.
Entrepreneur, that's me.
Ugly.
You name it, I do it. Ugly?
Ugly.
Me in the morning, and in the afternoon, and the evening sometimes, when I'm not lucky.
Okay, beauty.
Beauty? Skin deep. Definitely.
Dirty shoes.
Dirty shoes?
With scuff marks.
Clean feet? I don't know.
Okay. We have a caller. Wait a second. Maybe they want to play this name game, too. Okay. Alex. Maybe it's Alex. Hello?
I don't believe it. I can actually hear you now.
Okay.
Alex! God, I've been waiting for Alex, you for so long.
Are you there?
Well, I can't believe it.
I'm an accountant from Montecito. Not fairly good looking, but anyway. This is a great show, Ken. It's one of the best I've seen of all 50 years. But I have a question, Ginger. What do you think about when you pose in these shots? I saw an interesting look on your face.
You think about getting dressed, for one. I don't know. You just sort of, this is what I did. I would close my eyes before I'd start shooting, and I'd tell myself that there's like a little keyhole. And on the other side of this keyhole is this just intense man. And he can see me, and I have to act like I don't know that he can see me, but I know he can. So basically, that's what you're doing, because the camera is like, you know, that guy, and kind of have to ignore who's behind the camera. I mean, like, I didn't know Bob, but now I do. But when I went, I didn't know him. You know, but he didn't ever say, like, pose this way or pose that way.
Have you ever refused a shot?
Oh, yeah. Before I ever shot any of them, I went to the magazine and said, I won't do this. I won't do this.
What was that?
Basically, I don't like...
No, what was the pose?
If your ovaries are showing, you're doing the wrong thing. I'll just put it that way, okay?
On that note, we're gonna cut right now and get to a public service announcement. So stay with us. We'll be back right after this. As Tom Carroll says, don't go away. We'll be back right after this.
All right. God. Yeah. We always say that to the women.
We are back, continuing our conversation with Ginger Miller. Again, our phone number, 963-3893. I think we have the phones all worked out, so please call us. Ginger, okay, I already got your shoes off. Okay.
Right.
I've got the studio audience here saying, what, am I predictable?
Should I shock you? Would you like me to really shock you? Uh-huh. I mean, I've done it before, you know.
Okay, I'll shock you here. Look. No. Where the... We've got...
Look at this. Wait, now this is good. I've got your shoes off. Now I've got your jacket off.
And this...
Can we go for the tie, maybe?
This is rayon and a... embarrassing. Okay, here we go. We've got the...
It's okay. It happens to the best of us.
Okay. I don't know what
That's all? Come on. Be a little daring.
Here's my wristwatch. Okay.
Yeah, come on.
As we're kind of taking off our clothes, maybe. No, Daniel's on the line. Daniel, are you there?
Yes.
Okay, Daniel, you're on... Now you're live. What can I help you with?
Well, I kind of hate to interrupt this.
You want to see us go? What's your request, me or Ginger? Which article of clothing?
I would like to ask Ginger if kind of a 2 or 3 part question. One, with some same famous celebrity, if you could pick anybody to be on Desert Island with for one night, who would
be on what? Death Island?
On a desert island.
Oh, desert island. Okay.
One night. It'd be somebody famous so that we can all appreciate it. One night only.
How about 18 hours?
The second part of the question is you could pick somebody for 2 weeks on that same desert island. Who would it be? And then maybe for 3 months.
You want to go for a year or 5 or anything?
No.
I mean, I got a great payment plan.
One night, 2 weeks, 3 months.
One night, let's see.
I like that. Yeah,
for one night, I'd have to pick. See, I'm a businesswoman. You can tell it comes out every time I speak. One night, it'd have to be somebody like outrageously exciting. that wouldn't say anything. That'd be a big plus. I couldn't talk, but just like looked outrageous and did everything outrageous. This is one night. I could live with that. The two-week one would probably be good if they didn't talk either. 2 weeks can get pretty long. I don't know. And maybe a woman for 3 days, you know?
Are you, I mean, you like the company of someone who doesn't talk a lot or is animated, or you like someone who's very quiet or somebody who knows his
place?
No,
I've been around a lot of men that talk a lot and do too little, and I get really irritated with that, you know?
Ladies and gentlemen, barking dogs don't bite.
That's right. It's the ones that don't say anything. You gotta watch out for those guys. They're sneaky, you know? I don't know which is worse. At least you know what the other one's doing all the time.
Now, you're here in Santa Barbara. What next is happening for Ginger?
I'm going to Mexico on the 19th. Actually, I'm moving. I'm moving before that. I'm gonna buy a condominium. So that's what's next.
Good.
I'm shopping for a condominium. Then I go to Mexico. Spend 3 days in Acapulco with my store partner.
Yeah, this is the crazy one. Oh my God, there goes...
3 days, I'm going to have to like get ready like 2 weeks in advance,
you know?
Will
the Mexican government be the same? I don't know. Let's go now to Josh. He is on line one. Let's see if Josh, or maybe Alex, tried to beat him to it again. Let's see. Josh, are you there?
I'm here.
Okay, you're on the air live.
Yeah, I'm wondering, Ginger, I'm starting to be an accountant. Do you want to go out for a date? And if not, do you have a younger sister?
Actually, yes to both. I have a younger sister who is right now testing for Penthouse. Hopefully she'll be a centerfold soon. I'd love for her to be Miss September like I was. But the 20th, of course, because she gets like $500,000 worth of prizes.
Isn't it strange? So. It's funny. Here, I would think that, you know, so many people, you know, recognize you, and it's like any major star.
No, only when I take my clothes off.
No one recognizes you.
No. They
recognize you from the Broad Squad.
That's it.
But if somebody... sees you, it's almost as if they're familiar with you already. And for you to see them, when you see them, they're strangers. It's very odd, isn't it? It's kind of an uneven introduction, isn't it? Next.
Not really. You know, not really. See, you know really what my whole viewpoint on the whole thing is that it's a body. It's a centerfold, and it's not really that serious. You know what I mean? It's a centerfold. I mean, how seriously can you take a nude picture of a girl, you know? They're everywhere. They're always going to be everywhere.
I think people can be pretty serious.
You know? I mean, I have a body like everybody else. Sometimes it looks better at other times than it does at other times, but
let's get a wide shot. They've got it on me now. No. Worth it. Carrie, please. Let's stand up. Stand up. Carefully. Come here.
Do you want me to dance or anything?
No.
You guys have any ones? You know,
get up here. The penthouse pet of the year. Okay, wait a second here. Whoever, we're going to get this off. I want people
Bob
to see.
Bob Guccione paid $300,000 for this. You're getting it for free.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, I can't get through this jewelry.
It's okay,
here.
You're a lot cuter.
Thank you. A lot younger, too, huh, than Bob?
Bob, be aggressive, just yank it off.
Okay, there we go. Okay, now wait a second. Let's just put this over here. No,
if you take this
here.
Off, it's all over. This is all that's left. Can't lose the dress.
All right. Now look at this. You wonder where the Penthouse Pet of the Year is. She's in magazines, but not tonight. She's here in our studio. You turn around.
Oh.
Well, not all the way. We've got a mic on you. Look, perfect proportion. Do you have any problems with that? If you do, what is his name?
God, we could have had me interview in a bikini. Why didn't we have me in a bathing suit? You know, like right here. That would have been great, a bikini, a really little bikini.
So we should do part of the same thing, standing up, because, you know, the figure's attractive. Okay, but I'm having...
you want me to, walk as we're talking anything? Or do I, stand on
okay, now I'm hearing a director saying, no, you're getting off the camera. Now let's sit you down, okay.
Maybe I can stand in the chair so you can, talk to my cleavage. Would you like that?
Sit down. Okay, you got a good shot like this? Okay.
Yeah, there you go.
Yes. Are they real?
Oh, they?
Yeah.
Well, I own them.
Do they have to be
real?
I'm
honest, you know.
Do they have to be real?
I'm honest, huh?
Do they have to be real?
Do they have to be real?
You said Bob Guccione says that you have to have this a la natural.
Yes, every girl who ever appears in Penthouse has real breasts. It's a requirement. Are you kidding? I'm sure, no. There's so many of them that have had surgeries. I mean, yeah. But it's okay, you know, it's something to improve yourself. And some of them actually go smaller.
Really?
Not many.
I don't know. I wonder if you can say the same thing for Playgirl men. If They can just go small.
Playgirl?
Oh, that's a joke. It's not funny. Okay, JD's on the line. JD, are you there?
Yes,
live.
I am.
Okay, JD, it's getting kind of hot and.
Okay. Hey, Ginger, I think your breasts look good.
Oh, God, I thought that was my boyfriend for a minute. I was thinking JD.
Come on, it's my 25th birthday, and I'd like you to sing happy birthday to me, please.
Are you serious?
Sure.
All right, thank you. What's your name? What's your name?
JD.
JD, that's right. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Is there a lot of people there? You're having a birthday party? How fun. All right, I'll sing happy birthday to you. Will you sing it with me?
I will.
All right, ready?
Let's sing it backwards. Come here for a second. Turn this
backwards.
Way.
Backwards? Yeah, I can't do that.
Way.
Come on. That's smart.
This way. Go around this way.
This
okay,
way?
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear JD.
Happy birthday to you. All right, JD, thanks for watching.
And many more.
God, I've never done this without my shoes. It's like, where is everything?
You've never done that without your shoes?
Uh-uh.
See?
No. Have you ever worked without your clothes? No.
Who, me? I try not to make a habit of it, but it just happens to us girls sometimes, you know?
Okay, you know.
Can't help ourselves.
Just like JD just called, our phone number is 963-3893. What's the line you hear most from men, the approach line?
I'm a photographer.
Tonight we heard I'm a real
Yeah, hit. I'm a photographer. That and I bet you get a lot of guys asking you out all the time, don't you? That kind of a thing. Yeah, pretty much.
What do you have a standard answer, or is it something like, or what?
It's not as much as people think,
yeah.
You know? I don't know. I guess my head's just really geared towards business right now, so I really don't think about having a relationship. You know, I look at men if they're good looking. Of course, I'm human. But as far as when I meet people, I really sometimes have trouble just thinking of them in a sort of relationship aspect, because, you know, the job I'm doing isn't exactly conducive to having, you know, a serious relationship, and, you know.
Okay, well, we have a caller. Maybe they want a serious relationship.
Right.
I wonder if they do have, okay, we're going to.
I wish I would find somebody who would make me get serious. I would love it.
Okay.
I would really love it.
Maybe this is the caller.
Yeah.
Danny, are you there?
Yeah.
Okay, Danny.
Okay, I've got a serious question for Junior here.
Uh-oh.
On that bikini cola deal, I've got a whole case of her,
really?
I bought steel wrapped.
You have a whole case of bikini cola?
Yeah. I bought it when it first came out.
You should save it. It might be worth money someday, like Billy Beer or something, remember?
Yeah, okay. That's what I wanted to ask you.
Do you know when you drink it, the bikini comes off?
No, I didn't know that.
Oh, see, you haven't drank any yet?
No.
I'm kidding. Like, he falls for it. I'm sure. You guys believed me, didn't you, huh?
I also heard that.
See, I told you. They think they're full. Take off their clothes everywhere they go.
Oh, no, that's all I really wanted to ask you, and I think you look real terrific.
And so you have two cases. That's great. Can you send me a can? I don't have any at home.
You're kidding.
No, every can's gone. People stole them. I don't know what happened to them.
I have one full case, which is still wrapped, and then I have one can that's open.
Well, I wouldn't suggest drinking it now. It's a little old.
No, I wouldn't drink it.
Saving it?
Yeah.
That's nice. Thank you.
Thank you for the call.
Thanks for calling.
Bye-bye.
Every time someone served or slipped a drink down their throat, did you make some money off that?
No. I wish I would have. Yeah. That would have been nice. There was a lot of publicity. You know, we did an Eye on LA segment.
Yeah.
I mean, it was pretty neat because I was only 18 and I'd never done any modeling. And these little Japanese men are like talking to me saying, oh, can the coca, you know, thought that. They have all these cameras around their neck, and I'm going, yeah. You know? And they said, you know, how much, 2 hours. And I'm going, $300, $150 an hour. And I'm thinking, yeah, I'm ripping these guys off, you know, Miss Scheister here. My sister, $50 for makeup. She knows nothing about makeup, okay? So we go to this, we drive from Lancaster where I go to high school, we go downtown, downtown, big city, LA. She does my makeup like shit. We do the shooting, and 3 weeks later, a huge diesel, big truck, drives up with me plaster all over the side of this thing, okay? And these men in work outfits, I thought these guys were kidding. They come bringing in cases of this stuff, and I'm going, You were serious. I got paid $300
Ginger,
for it.
Ginger, we gotta go.
No residuals.
We gotta go. We're gonna hear.
It was
end
an
this
hour.
Story. Yes, it's already been an hour. We're gonna hear the end of this story after
That's
the show.
That's the end of it. It's gone.
Thanks for appearing on the 50th show.
Thanks for having me. It
Lovely.
Was fun.
Thank you very much.
Hey, you let me take my shoes off. I had a
Relax.
Good time.
Thank you. All right. 50th show. I'd like to thank you. Thank you all for watching. Of course, I'd like to thank my sponsors, Lions Limousine Service, for all their hospitality. Thank you again, Lions Limousine Service. Don't forget to call them if you ever need them. I also would like to thank, of course, Marty's Pizza and Metropolitan Theaters, Marilyn Free Enterprises, who did our makeup and hair, and MS Brenner Hair Studios, and Fanny's Flowers, brought flowers, Computerland of Santa Barbara, and also the Computer Doctor of Santa Barbara, our hotel accommodations, courtesy of the Four Seasons Biltmore. And thank you, Art and Sign Graphics, and of course, our newest sponsor, Pactuco of Goleta. So for my director, Carrie Graffy, and Ginger Miller.
Nobody else?
I'm Ken Boxer saying we'll see you around the town, and I hope it's really soon. See you next week. Bye-bye, everybody.
See ya.